All right, we're going to talk a bit more now about politics and focus on Wyoming in particular. The state of the GOP is in flux as we head toward the 2018 midterm elections, with many Republicans in the House and Senate facing challenges of their own. One such challenger could be longtime Republican donor Foster Freeze, who says he's exploring a 2018 bid for the U.S. Senate in Wyoming. He'd take on current Republican Senator John Barrasso. Joining us now to discuss is Freeze Associates founder Foster Freeze. Great to have you with us here in New York.
I'm glad to be here, right in the center of the washing machine with all the clothes going around.
You acknowledge you're thinking about this.
Yes.
What are you weighing? What are you considering at this point?
Well,
I wonder what your relationship's like with Senator Barrasso.
I never, ever would have considered a race until Bannon, you know, and he's a pretty prestigious
Steve
guy.
Bannon,
so
yeah.
I said, I'm going to maybe take a look at it. Then I find out it pays $174,000. I've been out of work since 2001. So I think it's seriously considered. And part of it is because I have an agenda item now called PatienceUSA.com. If you look at the Kingdom of D.C. versus we in the colonies, at the Kingdom of D.C., there's the insurance companies, the drug companies, and the hospital companies debating health care. Where are the three of us as patients? We're sitting in the sidelines with our doctors trying to figure out what they're going to decide when they decide. So PatientsUSA.com is an effort to give a patient a seat at the table. We plan to do that by starting with a one-line piece of legislation. Every provider of healthcare services and products, hospitals, doctors, everybody, is required to publish prices. Now, what's nice about that, it has a dual impact. Number one, it begins the process of reducing healthcare costs. You cannot reduce health insurance without reducing the underlying thing you're insuring. That's sort of, you know, that's economics 101. Mm. So as we begin that process of reducing those insurance costs, healthcare costs, we also develop a return to civility. And I think American people want that every bit as much as they want a good healthcare plan. And you cannot find in the colonies a Hillary supporter, a Bernieite, or a Trumpite who are not excited about publishing prices. It's just something. In fact, I said, puzzling, why hasn't it happened up to now? Why don't we have to know what a price of a delivery is? Mm.
Is that your main reason for considering this bid? I mean, when we see right now the race, Senator Barrasso, he is pretty popular still. I mean, he has held his seat with over 70% votes in the last two consecutive elections. So he's not really vulnerable for the GOP. Why target him now?
Well, first of all, that was Steve Bannon's idea. To me, this guy Barrasso is one of my heroes. In fact, the Christian community thinks that he created for the GOP platform one of the most God-fearing platforms in the history of the Republican Party. So I admire John and his lovely wife Bobby. So it's not so much I'm running against him, but there's a lot of people who like the idea of term limits. If he gets elected, he'll be in 18 years. And so what I am considering is, what do I bring to the table that maybe doesn't exist in the Senate, not just with Barrasso? For example, I do not understand why there isn't complete outrage about how our government has abandoned and it's just the Kurds
in Iraq.
Iraq. And what's so sad, you don't hear anything much on the news about it. It's a real problem, because they have been our friends for so long. And the Baghdad Shiite government last Wednesday just passed a law that might return what Saddam Hussein banned, and that is that adult men could again marry nine-year-old girls. Mm. And these are the people we're supporting. The person who took the command of the troops to take back Kirkuk was an Iranian general named Soleimani. If you look at the people leading the Shiites, one guy, they have a picture of him standing on an American flag. Another one they held in Abu Ghraib because he killed American soldiers is on the terrorist list. So we're supporting these people. Well, you say not supporting. Donald Trump said we're not taking sides. If you don't take sides, you're taking sides. And right now, all these troops of the Baghdad militias and the Baghdad army are positioned to take Indian Kurdistan, and it's an absolute disgrace. We've abandoned them, and we're traitors to them.
Let me go back to Stephen Bannon, the role he's playing in all of this, and help me understand here. Eric Prince, who's currently living in Virginia, is rumored to be thinking about running for Senate in Wyoming as well. He said that he's gotten a call from Stephen Bannon, too. So just help us understand the role he's playing here and what kind of variable that is, whether or not Eric Prince, again, who hasn't been living in Wyoming, how that complicates things for you, if at all.
Well, I kind of looked, what have I been given in life? I've been given wealth. I've been given a certain platform because I'm a member of a lot of the Republican Governors Association, and also a lot of people on the left like me, because in my whole life I've been kind of championing, what is this thing about America? When I was 17 years old, I confronted the seven motel owners in my little town and said, why aren't you accepting blacks and Jews in your motels? Why are you sending them up to Spooner 20 miles up the road? And then when I was the president of my fraternity, I orchestrated the first member of a Jewish guy in our fraternity. So, and also, I'm in favor of having some kind of statute of limitations for a five-year-old kid who was brought here, who's now 34 years old, working as an accountant for a nonprofit in Jackson Hole. Why you want to send him back? So a lot of things that I am in a position to champion, I think, are very embraced by the left, and it gets back to the return to civility. In the colonies, we Democrats and Republicans think a lot like this. There's a huge dichotomy between the Democrats in the colonies and the Democrats in Washington, D.C.
Freese Associates founder Foster Freese, thank you so much for joining us today on the program.
Coming up.